friends, today I'm going to do an iCAD, and this is one of my leftover stamps, cleaning off my stencils, going to use that. I'm going to probably use some of my pieces here. I was looking at, I got tons of these trims I made, borders, so I'm going to use some of that, and I think that's about it. I might just do some doodling or something like that on here. So I'm just going to kind of go with it and play with that, what I have. I think I'm going to do a nice stamped image of a leaf or a painted image of a leaf just for something different.
I have here ready,
I found a sponge stamp, and I got it from a Liquidation World place a while back, a couple years back or a year back or something, really long time ago. And I use it for, tend to use these types for material and stuff like that. I've actually used this to make this fern piece to make a silicone mold. So I used that and I just pushed it into the silicone, worked. And I use that for my little molds for my fern looking pieces. Anyway, so today I'm just going to use it with some Americana satin paint. And I'm just going to put that on the side here just a little bit. I'm just going to brush that on and use that as my stamped image here on here just for something different, just to do. So I'm just going to paint it on. It gives it a better coverage than dipping into the paint. And I got quite the wet brush. I'm hoping that I get a good stamp image. But I'm just getting it all over very well. Get that back in the water. And I'm just going to kind of curve. This has got, it was wet. I'm going to curve it down so then I'm not catching the sides as I'm going down. I'm going to push down. And I'm just going to look for my roller here. Miss! I'm just going to use my roller just because it's a sponge and just kind of roll it over, pushing more even pressure. So there we go. It was a little damp, got a little much liquid there, but that'll wash off my thing here, and that'll just have to be the way it is there. I'm gonna dry that up. So I didn't like dry off my brush very well, but still very pretty. So it's dry. I really put a lot of heat on it, so it bubbled up a bit, which I really like sometimes. I do that on purpose, and just it gives it a little extra unique texture. I don't know if you guys can catch that, because my camera sometimes doesn't want to focus. It likes to focus on my background, but not what I have in front of it. So that's so far what I got, and I'm just throwing it together, like putting things together. I'm not sure if I want to put, maybe I do want to put that in front. I was going to say, I wasn't sure if I wanted to cover it up a little bit even, but I kind of like that, so don't know. Kind of looking at it, seeing, well, do I want to have a border all around? Do I want a border just on the ends maybe this time? We'll see. Maybe I'll just do the borders on the ends this time. Getting my Mod Podge out right at the moment. Okay. And I think I'm just going to throw some Mod Podge down. Grab one end here and just give her like this. And get sticking down. cut my edge off. I'm going to do the same thing with the other side. So it's a very quick piece. Very quick piece of art to do. These little iCADs and index cards pieces. So if you just want to do a little something, that's what they're perfect for. You just want to do a little something creative. Isn't that pretty? And you can always add it to a card or something later. And so that's what I like about them. Give them a Happy Meal and stuff like that. So there, I think that one is just cute. Just cute the way it is like that on the edge. Okay, now I'm decided this one's going to go to somebody. So I'm just kind of like, I don't know. I like the whole thing and it's not like usual, but I'm going to put a stamped image on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my masking tape. So I'm like tapping everywhere here. Because what I want to do is I want to mask just over part of it here because I want to separate the words. So it says happy birthday. So I think if I just ink it up here, the happy birthday, because I like it. And I thought, well, you know, the cute little card for that. I'm going to push my happy down. I don't have my sponge in the back, but it's just going to be this little stamp. So my happy's right there. Now I'm going to stamp the other side. So I'm going to put, oh, I might have to rub some Windex on that there. Wipe it off after. Okay, because I'm going to remove it and I'm still going to have my old ink on there. That won't work. So birthday. So now it's going to be a nice little happy birthday card and then I can doodle on it. So that's that. Isn't that cute? And I should have actually taken off. I could have by chance. I actually did ink a little bit there, but there's the stenciling that doesn't show. My bad. Got to pay attention to what I'm doing. So now I'm just going to doodle on it and I think that project's going to be done. So it's going to stay relatively flat. I don't want it to be two dimensional. I have this. I'm going to probably put a little gold on there. That's really going to be cute. And I think that's going to be my goal. It's just a cute happy birthday card, index card. So I think that it's just kind of like, hey, came to me that I want to share that. So I'm going to add more border to it. I don't know. Sometimes you're like, do I do this? Do I add more of this, that? And today my drawing is really kind of shaky. That's okay. So I'm going to do the bottom. And I'm just using my calligraphy pen and the calligraphy ink, that, you know, the black ink. You buy it at Walmart. I got it for like $3 at Walmart, this ink. And it's been really good. Good to me. I haven't found any other colors there for calligraphy pens, but I'm sure you can use whatever. So that is that. I'm going to just keep doodling with it, maybe. Don't know. It's really hard to, tell. I could probably just do, see, I keep going and going. I'm going to do miss two, do this one, miss two. You could just do and do and doodle and doodle till the cows come home, I'm telling you. And I could do the same thing on this side. Putting my hands right in the face there, right where you guys can't see any. I just want to make sure I don't move my card or anything, so I'm going to miss two. Draw one. It's kind of spreading good. Like, but whatever. Good. It's all good. So. I'm just going to add some white. I should be a little careful. I probably shouldn't have put the little rounded circle in there till after, but whatever. But I'm just going to add the white to the ones that don't have a circle and just leave it like that. They have a little bit of something different. And these ones are pretty white, but I'm just going to add, have like a little spritz of color down there. And my red painters, add a little bit more color. And so that's going to be that. I'm just going to do a little bit in here. And I think that that's a nice index card. You can, like I said, I'm just going to be sending this one off for a birthday one. But I love using sponge or foam stamps as well as ink stamps. So sometimes, you know, you guys can just make your own or get your stamps out that your homemade ones and stuff like that and just play with them. And make some more or play with what you got. I'm just going to do a little inking with this script. I keep calling it scripture. It's not scripture, it's script. It's called script. And then just kind of ink that up like that in a few places. And I'm calling that one done. I'm just going to probably add the gold that I want to add on the lifted up pieces there. And this keeps falling off. But I use this end for stippling my black ink onto whatever I want. So I don't use it for painting. So there's that. I like that. More texture with the ink. I'm going to grab my metallic. My metallic lusters and gold rush, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of that, I think, on the tip of my fingers here, just like that. And I just want to add a little touch just to the stuff that's kind of sticking up there. See, I don't want too much, just like that. And now I think I'm done. So I hope you guys like that, and yeah, play with your foam stamps and paint and do something different. Okay, guys, I'll talk to you later. Don't forget to craft like a duck. Bye. Hope you enjoyed it.